Hans in luck. Hans served his master for 7 long years. Then he said, "Master, my time is now up. Give me my wages and let me go home to my mother." His master said, "You have served me well all these years. As you served me, so will I reward you." With these words, he avenue Hans a lump of gold as large as his he had. Hans tied the gold up in a bag, put it on his shoulder, and started home. As he walked along, he met a man on horseback. "Oh, what a fine thing it is to ride!" cried Hans. "It is like sitting on a chair. One gets to the end of his journey without stumping his toes against a stone." The man heard this and said, "Then, Hans, why do you go on foot?" "I have to carry home this lump of gold," said Hans. "It is the reward of my 7 years' work. It is so heavy that it hurts my shoulder and it pushes my head to one side." "Well," said the rider, stopping his horse, "I can rid you of that trouble. I will give you my horse if you will give me your lump of gold." "That I will, and thank you, too," said Hans. "But you will have a hard time carrying it." The man got down and took the lump of gold. Then he helped Hans mount and put the bridle in his hands. "When you wish to go fast," he said, "you have only to cluck with your tongue and cry, 'Get up!'" Hans was delighted to sit on the horse. For a while he rode all in slowly. Then he thought he should like to go faster. So he clucked with his tongue and said, "Get up! Get up!" The horse began to trail out. As Hans did not know how to stop him, he trotted butter and cheese to eat when I am hungry. When I am thirsty, I can have milk to drink. About noon the heat became great, and Hans grew thirsty. He was crossing an open field where there was no well nor spring in sight. "Now is the time," said he, "for my cow to give me a good drink of milk." He tied the cow to a bush on the roadside and used his cap for a pail. But not a drop of milk could he get. And as he was a very awkward milker, the cow gave him a kick that sent him sprawling on the ground. Just then there came by a butcher with a pig in a wheelbarrow. "What on earth is the matter?" asked he as he helped Hans to his feet. Hans told what had happened. The man laughed and said, "That cow has no milk to give. She is old and unfit for anything but to be killed for beef." "What a pity," said Hans, scratching his head. "She would make much meat, it is true, but I care little for beef. I like much better the meat of a fine fat pig like yours." "Then, Hans," said the butcher, "out of the kindness of my heart, I'll give you my pig for your cow." "On my word, that is kind of you," said Hans. So he gave the butcher the cow and took the pig. Soon he was joined by a boy carrying a goose under his arm. They began talking, and Hans told how lucky he was and what good bargains he had made. "See what a fine pig I got for my old cow," he cried. "Yes," said the boy, "but only see my goose, and feel how heavy it is. It has been fattening these 8 weeks. When it is roasted, how the fat will drip." "It is a fine goose," said Hans, "but not so heavy as my pig." The boy looked up and down the road and then shook his head. "I fear that pig will get you into trouble," he said. "I have just come through a town where a pig had been stolen from its pen. I fear it is the very pig that you have. The men are out looking for it, and it would be bad for you to be caught with it in your hands." Poor Hans began to be frightened. "Alas!" he cried. "What shall I do? Can you not help me?" "I run some risk if I do," said the boy, "but I have not the heart to leave you in trouble. I know the country better than you do. I will try to get away with a pig if you give it to me and take this goose instead." To this Hans gladly agreed. The boy hurried away with a pig, and Hans went on with a goose under his arm. "When I think of it," he said to himself, "I have gained by the change. I have a nice goose to eat. Then there will be goose fat to spread on my bread. Last of all, the beautiful white feathers will stuff a pillow. With my head on that, I shall sleep without rocking. How pleased my mother will be!" And now he came to a village. Here he saw a knife grinder turning his wheel. As he turned, he sang, "Old knives and scissors like new I grind, and round whirs my wheel as swift as the wind." Hans stopped to look at him. At last he said, "Your trade must be a good his pocket whenever he puts in his hand. But where did you buy that fine goose?"
"I did not buy it," said Hans. "I changed my pig for it."
"Oh, and where did you get the pig?"
"For that I changed my cow."
"And how did you come by your cow?"
"I gave for it a horse."
"And how did you get the horse?"
"Why, I gave for that a lump of gold as big as my head."
"And how did you get the gold?"
"It was my wages for 7 years' work."
"Well," said the knife grinder, "you are clever at trading. Now all that you need is always to have money jingling in your pocket."
"But how can I get that?"
asked Hans.
"Why, you must earn knife grinder like me," said the man. "You need only a grindstone. And, by good luck, I have one to sell. All that I will take is your goose in exchange for it. What do you say?"
"I say yes, with all my heart," said Hans. "I shall be the happiest man on earth. What more shall I need when I can always find money in my pocket?" So he gave the man the goose and took an old grindstone. "Now," said the knife grinder, handing him a smaller stone, "here is another good stone for you. On it you can hammer and straighten old nails. You'd better take this, too."
"I was surely born for good luck," cried Hans, his eyes dancing with joy. On he went. But now having walked since daybreak he began to be tired. The stones seemed to grow heavier at each step, and he could hardly drag himself along. "How much faster I could walk if I did not have these great stones to carry," he said to himself. He crawled at a snail's pace to a spring. Here he thought he would rest and get some cool water. He placed the stones on the brink and leaned over to drink. But by chance he struck the grindstone with his foot. Down fell both stones to the bottom of the spring. Hans jumped up singing for joy. "I am free from my heavy load through no fault of my own," he said. "These stones were the only things that I had to trouble me. Now they are gone. There is not a luckier man on earth than I am." With light heart and empty hands he ran on to his mother's cottage.